Hey guys, Anthony Cucciabona here, back with another video. And in today's video, we're gonna go over an update on the trades I made last on the marijuana stocks. And I'm also gonna give you an update on where I see Tesla stock going in the near to medium term. If you're looking to build your wealth in the stock market, you're gonna wanna subscribe. We talk about options trading, day trading, and swing trading here to achieve financial freedom. Give this video a thumbs up at the end if you appreciate it, and let's dive into the charts.
Like we discussed in the last video, we were talking about the weed sector heating up. We took profits yesterday morning, Monday, November 15th. Near market open, and we luckily took profits because we saw pretty bad sell-off and then a good bounce. We're just seeing profit taking now, and I think we're gonna continue to see a run, but for now I'm not in any trades. I'm in a lot of cash. I'm sitting on almost $500,000 in cash right now. I went out on the weekend, got poor sleep, so I wasn't as sharp Monday morning, and because of that I noticed that I was more concerned with protecting my gains instead of looking for new opportunities. I just saw more of like topping formation in the market, so I was more concerned on a savage pullback, so I took profits. And at first I was worried that I took profits too soon and I should have let it run more. But then after seeing what the market did, I was like, wow, okay, I'm glad I took profits. So Tesla stock sold off hard, went well below 1,000, down to like 978. And I thought it was a little aggressive. I could see us going down to filling the gap around low 900s. I bought one call option, just nibbling away the February 2022 expiration with the stock at 989. Here's an update on all the trades. So I'll go over one by one. We have Aurora Cannabis. We actually got up to 15,000 shares at an average cost basis of 790. 94K USD sold for $8.40 for a 7,600 profit from Friday to Monday. Taking a look at Aurora Cannabis on the daily chart here, everything still looks like a green light. You can see the RSI, if you really zoom in here, it's at 72.6. We're above the line, we're heading up. We had a 4.5% pullback yesterday on Monday, where it started the day green and then sold off. A lot of profit taking from those traders who were in on Friday and the day before. Stochastic is heading higher. We're still at the bottom of the MACD, opening up and heading higher. So on the daily chart, everything looks great. We just saw resistance where we thought we'd see resistance. In the last video, I said I'd be looking to take profits just before the $9 level because we could run into resistance. We actually topped out at about 869, and I ended up taking profits at around 840. Earlier last week, we went from the low sevens all the way up to 8, and then continued to go a little higher to a high of about 870, and then sold off. I started taking profits on the pullback. So as I saw the pullback happening, that's when I started closing out all my positions. Early around 10 a.m. I think we could see support around the high sevens, low eights, and then continuation to move higher in the coming week. For now, no position on my end. On the same day, Friday, when I recorded the video, Riot was at around $38, $39. By the end of that same day, it went all the way up to about $43 and then continued Monday, took profits, and then it sold off all the way down to about $42 by the end of the day, Monday. And then this morning in pre-market Tuesday, all the way down to about $37 based on Bitcoin selling off really hard to about the $58,000 level. I actually ended up selling puts for the end of the week at the 41 strike and the 38 strike. If those get executed, I would be okay with owning Riot at 41 and 38, because if we see the bounce on Bitcoin staying above 60,000, then we can definitely get back to that $40 level on Riot. Here we have Riot on the daily chart. As you see on Friday, pushed all the way up to even the $43 level. And then Monday had continuation, went all the way up to about 46, sold off hard all the way down to 42. After hours continued to go down, now at $37.50 in pre-market on Tuesday. So I currently have no position in Riot. On the daily chart, RSI still looks great with strength. Stochastic has flatlined, we're still heading up. Everything honestly still looks good for Riot. The only big red sign is that we dipped below the previous lows of all last week, which means that this could be the beginning of a downtrend where we could see bounces to go up, maybe seeing a $40 resistance level and continuing to trend down. If we're in a new downtrend for Bitcoin, then you best believe Riot is also in a downtrend. So it's important to keep that in mind. The miners still do move with Bitcoin. So if you're bullish on Bitcoin, you're likely bullish on miners. If you're bearish on Bitcoin, you're bearish on miners. So Riot, we took a total profit of 9,600 US holding from Friday to Monday. Tilray, we took profit on as well. Average cost basis of 1225, sold for 1340. I like Tilray as well for continuation. If you take a look at Tilray on the 1 hour chart, got the push all the way up to the high 13s, seeing that resistance just below 14, which was to be expected. We talked about that last time where we could see resistance around that level. And that's exactly what happened. We saw the sell-off, but again, it still looked great on the daily chart If we take a look at the daily, RSI is just about to get over the line. We could really see the continuation after this small pullback. Tilray was at a peak up about 5 or 6% on the day, and then continue to pull back with everything else, likely profit taking. We could see the run in the wheat stocks continue, but no position on my end. Last one here is on Roblox. Was seeing a lot of strength in the breakout. It was at all time highs on Friday. I was looking to play the continuation for next week. I sold for about 108.12, just about a 625 USD profit. Very small position on my end and small profit. The total profit from Friday to Monday was 19,000. And we're gonna talk about Tesla stock shortly because yeah, we're making all this profit, but we're losing a lot of money on paper with our Tesla stock position, of course. So Roblox has been having a ton of strength all the way up to about 109. It went to even like 110. Taking a look at the 1 hour chart, we saw this push up, we saw the pullback, and then the huge rally on Friday. And this is where we got in because we saw this strength here, where the RSI was looking great in the 1 hour, looking to play the break on all-time high to continue into next week. And it ended up selling off. I took profits just as it started pulling back at the low 108s. And then I thought I took profits too soon because it continued, but you'd rather take profits too soon than fail to take profits and have the stock go much lower than where you would have taken profits in the first place. Because that hurts way more when you just watch all your profits disintegrate and it comes all the way back to your cost basis and you break even at best, or possibly even lose money. If you watch your trade go deep in the green and then pull back to a loss and you take a loss on it, that is highly demoralizing. So you'd always much rather take profit early rather than watch yourself go in the green, go to break even, and then go in the red and take a loss. What I typically do on a lot of trades is if a trade really goes in my favor immediately, then I move up my stop loss to break even. At least that way you don't have a massive confidence hit if it goes back to break even and you get out. You'll feel okay mentally. So those were all the trades. We saw Blink have a massive run, which is threatening one of my strangles. So if we take a look at Blink, the short float is huge and they signed the infrastructure bill to create more charging stations. So it's currently respecting that resistance at 47. Luckily on my end, we're down in the pre-market 43.99. But remember, I rolled out the calls from the 42 strike to the 47 strike expiring December 3rd. So just because of that move, my short strangle became like another 15,000 USD loss if I would close it yesterday. But now on this pullback, it'll all that premium will get eaten up and we'll be okay. But just know that if we see Blink push up from 47 to about $50 level, I'm gonna have to roll it out again or just completely close out the Blink calls that I'm selling and take a loss on that position. But for now, we don't have to take any loss. Now we're gonna talk about Tesla stock, because I've talked about it in the previous videos, we're gonna continue to see the sell-off and it's totally expected. We're down to 1,002 pre-market. Yesterday, we fell all the way to about 978. We saw a lot of buying pressure later on in the day, taking us from 980 all the way up to 1,030. But the RSI and the stochastic didn't do much at all. We didn't get into any strength on the 1 hour whatsoever. So we're just gonna continue to see the sell-off. If you saw the news as well, JP Morgan is also filing a lawsuit for about 160 million on Tesla for failing to follow through on some warrants. We're seeing a lot of negative news come out on top of the overhanging suppression on the stock with Elon selling 1 billion a day. Yesterday, again, he sold another 1 billion, but he also exercised 2 million shares. So he sold about 1 million shares and then bought 2 million shares with his stock options. If we look at the daily chart and we go back to regular candles instead of Heiken Ashi, you'll see this huge gap on the breakout from 910 all the way up to 945. It's highly likely we go down to the low 910s and then have a huge bounce and get back up to the thousands. And then I think we'll trade sideways from about 1,000 to 1,100. Until early December, where there's the possibility of a stock split announcement. If we see the stock split announcement in December, then we will easily go back up to 1200 to close out the year. Also, in my opinion, I think Tesla is a great buy in the 900s. I personally, like I said, bought a call option when Tesla was around 989 expiring in February, because I do think when Elon's done selling, we will get a lot of buyers pushing this up to over 1,000, closer to 1100. And I might close on my call options there. If we also see the stock split be announced in December, then it's extremely likely that we'll go right back to all-time highs. Currently, I don't have any positions in any stocks. Like I said, I have about $500,000 in cash. I sold two puts on Tesla stock because I'm looking to buy about 200 shares of Tesla stock with that cash and also use that cash to pay for taxes. So that's kind of why I have about $500,000 in cash. The thought process is if Tesla stock goes down to 910 by the end of the week, then I'm forced to buy 100 shares at 910, which is awesome. And I also collected $3,000 in premium for that. The other one was I sold the $940 strike expiring at the end of November. So if Tesla stock is below 940 by the end of November, I'm also forced to buy another 100 shares at 940. And I collected another about $5,000 in premium on that one. I'll make a new video when I see other trades I'm about to go in. Let me know in the comments below what stocks you're looking at to trade. We're seeing Rivian still go absolutely insane. I might buy some puts soon. Market cap is gonna be at about $140 billion now with almost $0 in sales. So we're looking at twice the market cap of Lucid, which has more sales and in my opinion, better specs than Rivian. As we see the push go higher and higher, it's more likely that we're gonna see the pullback down to the low 100s. This could happen in 1 month, this could happen in 3 months. It's gonna happen, but we just don't know how long this could keep pushing up. That's the question that no one really has the answer to. But that will conclude the video, so thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate you watching. Give it a thumbs up if you appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next video.